Well, the Thomas Crane Public Library's free summer concerts on the lawn series are well underway on Thursday evenings. The next performance is coming up on Thursday, July 12th from 7 to 8 o'clock with the Island Grove Chorus. And we are joined by the director and the assistant, Pat Hoyt and Mary O'Loughlin, to tell us a little bit about the group, a little bit about the organization, and a little bit about what you will hear on that night. So ladies, welcome. Thanks for coming over.
Thank you for having us.
Great to have you both. Really appreciate it. Pat, let's begin with you if we can, and tell us a little bit about the Island Grove Chorus.
Yes, Island Grove Chorus is a member of Sweet Adeline's, which is a women's barbershop.
That was news to me to begin with, that there was such a thing.
Yes, yeah. Most people think men when they're
right.
Barbershop.
Yeah.
But our barbershop is really, it's a form of harmony that's a little bit different from your regular harmony that you'd hear from like a high school or college chorus.
Okay.
So we rehearse in Abington, the United Church of Christ. We welcome all women. And we have a great sisterhood and camaraderie in our chorus. And we love to perform and make the audience happy.
When did the group come together?
This particular group, I think, is about, we have our 25th.
We had our 25th
anniversary.
Yes.
Quite a while then.
Yeah.
Okay,
yes. It's an international organization, and they have choruses and quartets all over the world.
Really?
In Japan, Germany, England. So we are in Region 1, which is all of New England, mm-hmm. a little bit of upstate New York, and eastern Canada.
Oh.
So we have 23, I think it is, choruses in our region.
Okay.
Some are small. We're small. We're about 22.
Members?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then it goes up like to 120
really?
Member choruses.
All
yeah.
right. Okay. Now, are you both part of the founding members of the organization or no?
No.
Mary, you're shaking
no.
your head. No. Okay. So how long, Pat, have you been a member?
I've been a member, well, I've been the director since 2003.
Okay.
And I was a member before that.
Okay.
So 20 years.
Almost yeah. from the beginning then, yeah. Mary, how long have you yourself been involved in the Island Grove Chorus?
About 7 years. About 7 years, yes. I moved to Abington 8 years ago, and I've been in the chorus 7 years. And it's been wonderful. I'm the pitch pipe person, the treasurer, and the assistant director, and I got involved very quickly, and I love it.
And the webmaster.
Oh, and the webmaster, yes. I'm the webmaster, too. IslandGroveChorus.org and Facebook.
And how did you find out about it? I'm curious, did they reach out to you? Did you just hear about them?
I saw a sign in the library in Abington
okay.
and about looking for women singers, and I wanted to be another chorus.
Oh.
And then I went to a performance in Hingham with the men's barbershop, and I went there and I saw them sing, and I ran right up to Pat and said, I want to be in the chorus. Because they were all blingy and everything. And
right.
I like all that.
Oh, you like the flashies?
And I like to sing, too.
Yeah.
So.
Okay. So, Pat, how does one become a member of the Island Grove Chorus?
We're on the website. Look us up, Island Grove Chorus. We have business cards we can give out. We're going to give out stuff at the concert.
Okay.
All you need to do is come and probably sing for about 3 weeks. We give you a song to learn in a specific part. You know, I take their range and see how high or low they can sing.
Yeah.
And then you audition in a quartet, which everybody is nervous about,
sure.
but it's not threatening at all.
All right.
And I have to know you can sing your part against the other three parts.
Okay.
That's all.
Okay.
But nobody's died yet from doing it. So.
So it's not really an audition, so to speak. It's,
right.
it's just
yeah, and it's not
test.
In front of the chorus okay. or anything. So, yeah.
Now, do you have formal musical training background?
I myself don't really have formal training,
yeah.
although I've been a musician all my life.
Oh.
And I play piano, cello. And I sing, of course.
Mm-hmm.
And when I joined the chorus, I said, okay, I'm just going to join and sing.
In the background,
and then
right?
I became
You drew
director.
The short straw, as it were, yeah.
No, it's a lot of fun.
I bet it is. Yeah.
I try to make every rehearsal fun.
Sure. Where do you rehearse, you mentioned before?
Abington, UCC.
Okay.
Yeah.
And weekly, monthly?
Weekly on Tuesday nights.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So if you're interested, you can come maybe to a rehearsal and see you in
action. Oh, yeah.
In action.
Just come right down.
Okay.
We'd love to see people walk through the door.
Sure. Mary, how about yourself? Did you have formal musical training or background?
Well, I played the piano. I sang in a lot of choruses.
Yeah.
I did a lot of theater. I was a school teacher in Boston for 35 years,
Oh, all right.
So,
okay.
And I did a lot of, I was a lot of a director in theater and a producer and things like that.
I see.
So,
okay.
I did that. And I did a lot of harmonies. So when I joined, I loved it.
Yeah.
And I sing the high part. There are four parts in Barbershop.
Oh.
And I'm the tenor, and I sing the high part. And Pat was the baritone, which gives it the Barbershop ring.
Yes.
And then there's a bass, which people sometimes don't think that women are basses, but we have basses.
Really? Okay.
And then our lead part is the part that does the melody.
Okay. All right. So what is, you know, Barbershop music? I mean, is it known songs that are done in a different harmony or a melody, or is it original works written just for Barbershop?
Well, it could be both, really.
Okay.
But basically, it's known songs, like a lot of old-time songs, right, Pat?
Well, they started, the women's group started in 1945 because all the whites saw that the men were having fun and they weren't.
Oh, really? Okay.
So they started their
own
group.
What's fair is fair.
But I mean, back then it was all, you know, down by the riverside and stuff like that. But it's grown from then to popular songs, and like we're doing some Beatles songs and patriotic songs and popular songs. And she was saying that the baritone, that's the difference, because the lead sings the melody as opposed to a soprano singing the melody up high. So it's in the middle, and the baritone sings all around it. Like if you had Happy Birthday, the baritone would be Happy birthday to you.
Okay.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Mark. Happy birthday to you. So that's the part that gives it the barbershop harmony.
I see.
And when you ring a chord, what they call that, you actually hear a fifth note above it. Huh. If that chord is in tune and rings.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is the entire chorus coming here to Quincy?
Most of them, some of them, I guess, have other things they had already planned.
Okay.
But
the choruses and the quartet. I'm in the I'm in our quartet that we have so far.
We're the formidables.
We're the formidables. Yes. So we also will sing some songs too.
Oh, fun. Okay. Yeah. All right. Now, give us a little hint or teaser. You mentioned Beatles songs. What else might be? What might we hear that evening?
I'm trying to think. Well, we do Crazy. We do Stepsister's Lament. We do things like that.
Okay.
We did. Side by Side, so there's an old one, and then some new ones, and Get Happy. We have our own repertoire, and we go around to places like nursing homes and things like that, and do our women's groups, and we sing for them too.
Oh, that's great. That's wonderful. So your audience could be young or old, right? Or anybody in between. Yeah,
that's great.
And for folks who don't know what barbershop music is, this would be a good opportunity. You're out on the lawn, which is a beautiful setting if the weather's good, but if not, right in the community room on the ground floor there, which is a nice setting too. It's got great acoustics. You've seen it, Pat.
Oh, I've been in there. It's nice.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. Curious, this is obviously not your day job.
No.
Do you have another a career that you...
My day job is retired.
Good for you.
I used to teach school, and then
you did too.
I was in medical records.
Okay.
I worked at Mass General.
Okay.
So, no.
This is
but
the
I'm old enough to be retired.
This is the fun part, right?
Yes. Definitely.
Very good. We are going to give our viewers a little sneak peek here, so we'll ask them to stay tuned to the Island Grove chorus and get a little sampling of what you might see. But anything else that you ladies wanted to add for this coming show?
I just want to tell everybody that a lot of people say, oh, I can't sing, but everybody can sing. And so just because you don't have like an operatic voice or anything, you know, come, because we don't want that vibrato in our tone. So just come listen and try it out.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a great hobby.
It has been for you so far, right?
Yes, you make a lot of friends.
Yeah. Go a lot of places and do things. It's really fun.
Anything else, Mary, you'd like to add?
No, just like Pat said, just come and try it out. Yeah. You know, and even like people that have very low voice, they might think they can't sing because they can't get up there to that melody.
Yep.
But we definitely need the basses, too.
All right.
So, yeah, any range.
Okay, great. Yeah. Well, thank you both for coming in and talking a little bit about the chorus. And thanks for coming to Quincy. Have a wonderful performance.
Oh, thank you very much.
You're very welcome. Again, that's the Island Grove Chorus, part of the free summer concerts on the lawn at the Thomas Crane Public Library, Thursday, July 12th at 7 p.m. If you'd like to get more information about this or any of the programs at the library, check out their website, thomascranelibrary.org.
I was blue, just as blue as I could be Every day was a cloudy day for me Then good luck came knocking at my door Noticing the days hurrying by when you're in love.